We are the Israelites that the Bible speaks to. You understand that? We are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of, so-called Black, Latino, Native American. Okay? However, we forgot who we were. Go to Baruch chapter. Okay? We forgot. Now, today, we're considered Blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, right? Did you know you were an Israelite?
Say that again?
Did you know you were an Israelite? Come here for a second. Let me show you something. You're in a rush. Is your woman in a rush or are you in a rush? You're an Israelite, according to the Bible. Read that.
The book of Baruch, chapter 4, verse 1. This is the book of the commandments of God.
This is the book of commandments that belong to the Most High God, and He gave it to us. The brother brought it out earlier. This book, brother, is your book. And it's a book of commandments that you're supposed to be following. Read it again.
This is the book of the commandments of God.
Come on.
And the law that endures forever.
This law endures forever. You so-called Blacks, Latinos, Native Americans. You understand that? Bro, you understand that? Do you understand that? These commandments are given to you so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. You know?
All day that keep it shall come to life.
All of you so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans that keep these commandments shall come to everlasting life. Come on.
But such as leave it.
But some of you, the rest of you that don't keep these commandments,
shall die.
Will be put to death when Christ comes. Right now, we're in the grace period. Right now, we got time to get it together. You understand? The Bible says a just man falleth 7 times. We have a chance to fall, and we have a chance to get back up again. We have a chance to sin, and a chance to repent and stop sinning. You understand? These are things that are in the Bible, and if you don't pick up this Bible, if you don't subject yourself to learning these commandments, you ain't never gonna get it. You understand? But a lot of you just walk around aimlessly in a rush. You know who you are according to the Bible? Come here for a second, let me show you. What's your name, bro? Edwin, my name is Abiel. These are my brothers, all right? Where's your father? Okay. From what I'm seeing, from what I take, from the tribe of Judah, okay? The Bible says that we're Israelites. Read that again. Watch this. You believe in the Bible? Okay, good. Let me show you what this Bible is about. Okay. Watch this.
The book of Baruch, chapter 4, verse 1.
Go ahead.
This is the book of the commandments of God.
The Bible is a book of commandments given by God to you, Edwin, to us, so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Okay? You done?
And the law that endured forever.
Before you were born, this Bible was around. When you die, God forbid, when the day comes, you die, or when Christ returns, this Bible is still going to be around. But it's forever.
All day that keep it shall come to life.
You, Edwin, if you keep these commandments, you will come to everlasting life. Okay,
but such as leave it.
But if you leave this, or if you don't open it, if you don't read it, live it, and understand it,
shall die.
Death when Christ returns. Or you will die naturally or a horrible way. You understand? Read on.
Verse 2. Turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it.
So you're from Jacob, right? Jacob is our forefather. Okay? Now, the Bible is telling you, turn ye, O Jacob, meaning turn ye, O Israel, and come back to these commandments. Go ahead.
Walk in the presence of the light thereof.
And keep the commandments, is what it's saying. You understand? Read on.
That thou mayest be illuminated.
What does illuminated mean? Illuminated means enlightened, or get that understanding. You know, when you get an idea, you're like, oh man, just came to me. That's what illuminating. Right now, we're trying to bring it to that state of illumination. You need to understand, damn, you know, you need to tell me that I'm an Israelite. You need to tell me that I'm chosen. Me, Edwin? I'm chosen? Bro, I'm in the hood. Just like you. You mean to tell me that you're special? These brothers right here are special? Really? Nah, you bugging. Yeah. You're a king, bro. But the thing is that we're not acting as kings because we're running around. You understand? You know,
verse 3. Give not thine honor to another.
What we've done as a nation is we've given our honor to another. How? Look at the names, look at the businesses that we have right here. Edwin, honestly, I can tell you're an intelligent man. You understand? Don't you think you should have a business on your home block? A real legitimate business? A storefront that says Edwin's whatever, Emporium, whatever, or Edwin's Emporium, whatever. But no, our honor has been given to other nations. You got the Arabs, you got the Chinos right here, you got a Korean cat, or a Chinese guy that runs this pharmacy. You understand? We got Mexicans that have it there, yeah. But you know who they report to? They report to a Jewish guy that owns the building, that actually owns the entire building. So that really isn't ours. You understand? But how come we've given our honor to another nation? Look at our women. Our women dye their hair blonde or brown to look like a white woman. Or like a white woman. Yes, you, I'm talking to you. Our women straighten their hair, they kill their hair, they put chemicals in their hair to straighten their beautiful natural hair, and they make it dead. You understand? Why? Because they hate themselves. We've given our honor to another nation, you know?
Nor the things that are profitable unto thee to a strange nation.
This Bible is profitable, meaning it will give you profit unto you. It is worth more in your hands. It's useless in their hands because it wasn't made for them. It was made for you.
Verse 4. O Israel, happy are we, for things that are pleasing to God are made known unto us.
They're made known unto us, the Israelites. You're an Israelite. Read on.
Verse 5. Be good, be of good cheer, my people, the memorial of Israel.
You are the memorial of Israel, you understand? Be cheerful, because well, as a people, we're depressed, you understand? Look what happened in St. Louis. Yeah, a few of our brothers getting shot to death, you understand? But in that horror, we still have to be cheerful because this truth has been given to us. We still gotta keep it moving. We still gotta keep it teaching, you understand? Done.
Verse 6, ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because ye moved God to anger.
Why were we put into slavery? Why did blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans go into slavery? No. Read that again.
Ye were sold to the nations.
Stop. Were we sold unto nations? Did this happen? See that? Those are the Arabs that put us in slavery. Did that happen to us? We didn't draw this. We got this. We compiled all these pictures and put them on a board so that we could remember. Look, this really happened to us. Look, you got a white guy examining one of our people. Why? Because he wants to make sure he ain't got no diseases and he can go ahead and work in his field. You understand? These things actually happen. But the Bible's, now the question was this. Why did we go into slavery? It wasn't what you said was.
I feel like they were scared of it. Strong people, you know, they wanted to put it down.
You partially right. However, here's the real answer.
Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction.
So we were sold into slavery not to destroy us,
but because ye moved God to wrath.
Because we pissed God off. That's the reason why we went into slavery. Because we got God so angry that he said, oh, God, to hell. Just, you don't want to serve me? Fine. Go into the other nations, you're going to be their slaves. But you're going to understand in the future why I sent you into slavery. It's because you're pissing me off. That's the reason why we went to slavery, because we got God so angry. Read on.
Ye were delivered unto your enemy.
We were sent into our enemies for what?
For ye provoked him that made you.
Because we provoked them. We moved God's hand against us. You understand? That's the reason why today we live paycheck to paycheck. Why we try to make ends meet and those ends never meet. This is the main reason why we have black on black crime, Latino on Latino crime, black and Latino crime. The Native Americans are, you know what I'm saying? They're messed up too. They're on reservations. They're in the hood also. Only difference between their hood and our hood is that they're surrounded by mountains and coyotes. But the situation is that we broke God's commandments and now we're going to suffer for it. However, we have a chance for that. Go to Joel real quick. Joel. All right, I'm going to show you more about the slave. Yo, that girl can wait, bro. You know why?
The store.
The store?
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 1. For behold, in those days and in that time, when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem.
So the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem is the nation of Israel, Jerusalem, and the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. You understand? ¿Tiene una pregunta?
No, but I'm listening.
Okay, yeah, read on.
I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
Question for you. What is happening right now?
There's a controversy.
I like that word. Controversy. Everything is happening right now in the Middle East. Okay, and we're talking about it right now. Yeah, read that again.
I will also gather all nations.
All nations are gathering. They're converging right now on that area. Go ahead.
And will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
Meaning the valley of judgment. Go ahead, read on.
And will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage, Israel.
Now, the Most High is allowing all that to happen so like that he could bring us, so like that he could bring us out of here and bring us back into our land. Because as the brother said earlier, there is a controversy going on. The controversy is that there's other people in our land. There are other people in your land, bro. In your land. Rihan.
Whom they have scattered among the nations.
And how were we brought into America? By cargo slave ships, very good.
How did Latinos get into
in the Caribbean islands? Bro, how did Latinos get into Puerto Rico, into Venezuela, Santo Domingo? How did we get there? By ships. But we came here on our own accord, and we're gonna read that in a moment. But then when the conquistadors came, we were taken by ships into another land also, and we became slaves over there also. I'm gonna get to that in a moment. Read.
And parted my land. Verse 3.
Meaning that these other nations parted our land, which is Israel. Hold that, go to Galatians chapter 4 and 26. Let me prove to you that Africa is not our homeland. Puerto Rico is not our homeland. Santo Domingo and all these other nations are in our
Santo
homeland.
Domingo, Malibu.
No, nosotros somos de Israel. Tú también.
The book of Galatians, chapter 4, verse 26. But Jerusalem,
pero Jerusalén, go ahead,
which is above,
que está encima or on top, right,
is free,
es libre, go ahead,
which is the mother,
que es la madre,
of us all,
de todos nosotros. The motherland is Jerusalem, which is in Israel. Where are you from?
All right.
Santo, you said Santo Domingo. Okay. ¿Dónde aquí? ¿Dónde dice que de dónde tú eres? De acuerdo de Tereo. De
oh, yeah,
Santo Domingo.
Santo Domingo.
Simeon. Pero cuando nosotros fuimos en esclavitud, nos dijeron dominicanos, puertorriqueños, morenos.
But no, tú eres de Simeón, yo soy de Efraín y ellos son de Judá. Okay? That's why today we're all confused. We have no understanding as to who we are, so that's why we'll represent Santo Domingo on the float, in the parade. We'll do all those things, but we really don't have an understanding as to where we come from. You understand? Now, read on.
This is the information. Powers that be.
Yes, exactly. Now, actually, no. Go to. Watch this. Let me show you how we got here first. Five scriptures. Let me show you how Boricuas, how all Latinos got here. So North America and the other islands and everything.
The book of Second Esdras, chapter 13 and verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmanesar, the king of Assyria, led away captive.
So now it's telling you the time frame as to where we were, the 10 tribes, which is from here on down. Okay?
And he carried them over the waters. And so they came into another land.
So now, we went from Israel and we went into Assyria in slavery, in captivity. All right, the 10 tribes, go ahead.
Verse 41, but they took this counsel among themselves.
So now, it's going into the future a little bit. When King Cyrus became the king of the known world, okay? King Cyrus gave us the opportunity to go back to our land and rebuild, all right? So, you know, because a person that goes ahead and wants to do, a slave can't do whatever he wants, but a free slave or a free man can do whatever he wants. He has the liberty to do whatever. King Cyrus gave us the liberty to leave. So now, read on.
That day would lead the multitude of the heathen.
Because we wanted to leave the other nations. The other nations always had us in chains and shackles, but now it's a different thing because we're free. Go ahead.
And go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
So now, let me ask you. I'll show you. According to this right here, you see this, you got Africa, you got the Middle East, right? Okay, this is the known world at the time. This is the unknown world. Now the Bible said that we'll go to a land, to a further country where never mankind dwelt. Where is that land? According to that scripture, it would be here because it's unknown. No man ever lived here. This is the land. Read on.
Verse 44, that they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land.
Because when you can go into a place where no one's ever lived, you can do whatever you want. You can set laws, you can set boundaries, you can separate the people, you can put, if you want, look, you know what, I'm gonna build a temple here, I'm gonna build a house over there. You understand? You can do whatever you want because no one's ever been there. You're claiming it for yourself. That's what we did. Read on.
Verse 43, and they entered into the Euphrates.
But now it's getting specific. We entered into the Euphrates River. This is the Euphrates. All right, go ahead. We're going to keep on teaching. This is the Euphrates. Read on.
By the narrow passages of the river.
You understand? That's how Latinos got here. You understand that? Read on.
Verse 44. For the Most High then showed signs for them and held still the flood.
You understand that? You hear what it said? The Bible is actually talking about how Puerto Ricans got here. That's okay. Where are you from? Your what?
The good thing is that you understand English. So la clase en inglés. You know, so you'll be able to, and you'll get a more controlled setting.
Uh-huh. You
know? Yeah. Dude, okay, looking forward to it.
Why? Because I want, I'm interested.
I have to go to work.
I'm interested. Well, actually, right now you're having a poquito. If you want to, if you had to go to work so bad, you wouldn't be here right now. Sucking on a poquito. You'd be at work.
I am working, actually.
Okay. So while you're having a poquito, let's engage in conversation.
Because
what?
I have to call the
break. Right. You know.
Good,
so till we were passed over, meaning through the Euphrates River, read on.
Verse 45, for through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half.
So it took us a year and a half from Assyria to get over here. That's how Latinos got here, you understand? This is how Latinos got here. But our people don't realize how important this truth is. They would rather waste time on a corner than to come and learn their true heritage and believe that they're from Spain. But when you look at your last name, anyone, blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, who are the Israelites, you're always going to be reverted back to Spain.
That's right.
Ancestry.com is a lie. Your last name belongs to a slave master that happened to be from Spain or from Europe. You understand? I had to say it that way because Latinos think that Spain is separate from Europe. So I had to word it that way. You understand? You're not Spanish. And the brother always brings out, the word ish is the characteristics of. You understand? We speak Spanish, but we're not from Spain. We speak English, but we're not from England. We are Israelites from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Latinos, or blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are the Israelites of the Bible speaks of. Okay?
Give us Jeremiah 17.
Okay? You're confused. You are confused in your own ignorance. You're confused, but don't worry. That ignorance was given to you. You just accepted it. Confused. We have another understanding that was given to us. Okay, in slavery.
The book of Daniel, chapter 9 and verse 7. O Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee.
Because the righteousness belongs unto the Most High. The Most High gave us the ability to go ahead and teach. Go ahead, don't worry about it. Go ahead.
But unto us, confusion of faces.
We are confused. Our women are confused because they want to look like this sister over here. They want to look like a white woman. They go ahead, they color their hair and they straighten their hair and they want to look like someone else. They don't want to look black. But didn't you know that you so-called sisters are beautiful in your natural ability? You're beautiful. Why change that? Read on.
As at this day.
As at this very day, you are confused. You don't want to keep the beauty that you have, but you want to alter it and make it horrible. But in your confusion, you think that you're beautiful. Okay? Read it again.
Oh Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee.
Look how pretty. Look how what a beautiful family. Why do you want to grow up and destroy that? You understand? We have confusion of faces. We want to look like the other nations. Straightening our hair. Coloring your hair for what? You're naturally beautiful. Work with what you got. Read on.
But unto us, confusion of faces.
And we are confused as a people. We are confused thinking that we're from Africa with the Santeria. That's out of order. The Most High never told us to go and yes, you. The Most High never said that Chango was supposed to be your protector. God God never said that about the law is going to protect you. That is out of order. Where in the Bible?
Oh, Lord, rest.
Where in the Bible does it talk about us being subject to saints? You have no idea who the saints are. Psalms chapter 147. Get that.
Book of Psalms, chapter 147 and verse 19. He showed his word unto Jacob.
The Bible was shown unto us, Latinos, Morenos, Indio Nativo. You understand? Go ahead.
The statutes.
El Señor, tú tienes una pregunta.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
The Bible is given unto you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. That is it. Read on.
He hath not dealt so with any nation.
God has not dealt so with no one else. You understand? You have a question? You go like this. Come here. Back off. Back off, momento. No te da miedo. You want to give me a thumbs up? Good. Don't pick on me. Come on, man. Get on.
And as for his judgments, they have not known them.
And for his judgments, they have not known them. These other nations have no idea who they are. They know who they are. You don't know who you are. But you want to go ahead and you want to deal with the other nations. You have no ability. You have nothing to do with the other nations. Okay, read that again.
He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He has not dealt so with any nation.
God never gave this Bible to everyone. God only gave this Bible unto you so-called blacks, Latinos, Native Americans. That is it.
That's right.
You understand? Where you from, bro? Let me guess. Puerto Rico. According to your shirt says Puerto Rico. So where you from? From the planet Earth? Okay. What part of the Earth?
Exactly. I don't know. It looks like a crater.
It looks like a crater? Okay.
He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his commandments unto Israel. He has not dealt so with any nation.
So the Bible says that this Bible wasn't given to everyone, okay? This Bible has been given to you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, okay? And as we read earlier, there's confusion of faces, okay? From what I see on you, you're confused. You understand? You have a yin-yang, you have a lot of jade on you, you have a crucifix on your arm. Actually, two crucifixes on your arm.
Yo.
You understand?
Yo, turn that camera, man.
Nah, listen, we're here to protect ourselves. Listen, we're no fools here. You understand? We are no fools. We will defend ourselves. You see us here with Bibles, but I'll tell you what. We will defend ourselves, all right? There's no threat that you can give us. Okay? We're here to teach you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans who you are and where you come from. Sister, you came here last week. You came here last week and you're still bumped out of your mind. We will not deal with you. Yes, read that.
Watch this.
The book of Psalms, chapter 97 and verse 7.
This is for you, bro.
Confounded be all they that serve graven images.
You are confused in graven images. Sister, that the sign of the cross is out of order. That's not in the Bible. Tu hablas español? Yo también.
Nosotros no te vamos a orar por ti. ¿Sabes por qué? Porque tú tienes que hacer lo que Dios dice primero. La semana pasada nosotros le dijimos que tú tienes que venir modesta. ¿Tú ves cómo ella está? ¿Tú ves cómo ella está vestida? Señora, sí, varias veces te vi. ¿Tú ves cómo ella está vestida? Cuando tú puedas regresar, ve, como ella, así, vestida bien. ¿Ok? Tú estás muy corto. Tú estás enseñando demasiado, señora. ¿Tú quieres? Nosotros tenemos que hacer lo que la Biblia dice. Okay, pero Dios no le gusta.
They boast themselves of idols. Worship them, all ye gods.
You boast yourself with idols. You understand? You want to deal with the other nations? You
host yourself with idols. You want to be a Santeria and Brujeria? You want to come up here and bring confusion? That's out of order. We're going to deal with you. Understand? We're going to deal with you. We're going to open these scriptures and we're going to bring it out. Thus saith the Lord. Read that again.
Confounded, they boast themselves of idols. Worship him, all ye gods.
Deuteronomy 28. You understand? You want to go ahead and worship these other disgusting things, these idols and stuff like that. You want to deal with these other nations. You want to get wrapped up in these idols. You're confused. You understand? Christianity is a damn lie. Catholicism is a damn lie. You understand? Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 29. And thou shalt grope at noonday, as the blind gropeth in darkness. And thou shalt not prosper in thy ways. And thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore. And no man shall save thee.
And that's exactly what's going on. We as a people are groping as the blind groping in noonday. In the noon, high noon, you got the sun out. You see everything. But you're blind. You're groping at noonday. You're blind in Christianity. You're blind in Santeria. You're blind in Brujeria. You're blind in every single denomination that's in this planet. These denominations weren't given unto us. But you're blind in your own God. You're blind with the God of your own imagination. You understand? You're groping at noonday. Read that part again.
And thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
Not?
And thou shalt not prosper in thy ways.
Stop. And we will not prosper in our ways. Why do you think we have Section 8 in our community? Because we're blind to Christianity. We're blind in Christianity. We're blind with these other religions. We're blind with our own ideas as to what God is trying to say. That's why we're not successful, because we're not keeping God's commandments. And a lot of you Christians believe that you believe in Christ, but you have no idea who Christ is. I tell you that Christ is black, and now there's a problem. Or you would say, it doesn't matter what Christ looks like. You're blind and you're groping at noonday. Read on.
And thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore.
And our people are spoiled evermore. We are destroyed as a people. We're confused with other faces. We have confusion of faces. You understand? We are dealing with other things that are outside of the Bible. And that's the reason why we're suffering everything that's going in our lives today. That's why we have single mothers. We have single fathers. The children are out of order. You understand? You got divorce, alimony, all these wicked things that are happening in our lives. We're even walking to the police and getting shot. Telling them to shoot us because we're so frustrated. What are you doing? You're going about it the wrong way. You're going out of God's way. And you're getting in God's way because you want to be God. Read that again.
And thou shalt grope at noonday, as the blind gropeth in darkness. And thou shalt not prosper in thy ways, and thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore, and no man shall save thee.
Because that's what we're expecting. We're expecting for another man to come and save us. Oh, Mr. White Man, please, look at what happened in Katrina. Everyone was waiting for helicopters and all this stuff to come through to save them. But no, it wasn't happening. You understand? You want the white man to come, but you won't expect your... We as a people have enough resources to help ourselves. But you know what? We don't trust each other. We don't want to do it. The Most High says that you're a special people. Get that, Deuteronomy chapter 17. Verses.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art a holy people.
God said that you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans are a holy people. The word holy. mean special. Venerated. You understand? Important. A VIP. Read on.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Unto God, meaning God is the one that only finds you, so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, to be special. Read on.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people.
No. You read that wrong. Read it again.
Above all people.
Well, it looks like he didn't read that wrong. The Bible says that you are you. Yes, you. You are above all people. Read on.
That are upon the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because ye were more in number than any people, for ye were the fewest of all people. But because the Lord loved you, and because he would keep the oath which he had sworn unto your fathers, hath the Lord brought you out with a mighty hand, and redeemed you out of the house of bondmen, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
The Most High didn't do that with anybody else. Okay? God is the only one that took us out of Egypt, out of slavery, with a mighty hand. He didn't do that. He doesn't do that with all nations. He doesn't do that. He has a chosen group of people. That's us. You understand? That's us, you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Okay? We're God's chosen people, but right now we choose not to be his people. Okay? Wrapped up in buying and selling, breaking God's laws, breaking God's Sabbath. Okay? Going ahead and doing things that we want to do, but we don't want to do what God says, huh? Go to long.
We're frustrated with the slavery and stuff like that. We're frustrated. Getting up in the morning, working and all that stuff, but there's a reason why we're in the situation that we're in today. You understand? There is a reason as to why we're in the situation that we're in. It's because we broke God's commandments. Okay?
The book of Baruch, chapter 3 and verse 8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
If you don't believe that we're not in slavery today, you are out of your mind. You're out of your mind. We are still slaves in this kingdom, in this captivity. We're still slaves today. Read it again.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse.
You understand what it's saying?
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Hoy día nosotros somos esclavos. Eso es lo que la Biblia está diciendo. Mira.
Where thou hast scattered us.
Porque Dios nos mandó acá en esclavitud. Okay, read.
For a reproach and a curse.
Como si fuera una maldición. Okay? Porque nosotros no queríamos hacer lo que Dios dice. Read on.
And to be subject to payment.
Y para estar sujeto a pago. Hoy día nosotros cuando pagamos, pero realmente un esclavo paga. ¿Se dice?
And to be subject to payment.
Nosotros estamos sujetos a pago. Okay? Tarjeta de crédito, renta, en Medicaid, Medicare, todas esas cosas. La comida que nosotros compramos todos los días, nosotros todavía a este día estamos en esclavitud. ¿Ok? ¿Pero por qué? Porque nosotros rompimos los mandamientos de Dios. Eso es lo que dice.
The book of Baruch, chapter 4, verse 1. This is the book of the commandments of God.
Lo que dice, esto es el libro de mandamientos que le pertenece a Dios. ¿Qué es?
And the law that endures forever.
Y la ley que está hecho para siempre. You know?
All they that keep it shall come to life.
Todos nosotros que son de los 12 tribus de Israel, que mantienen estos mandamientos, van a llegar a la vida eterna. You know?
But such as leave it.
Pero los de los 12 tribus de Israel, los que no mantienen esos mandamientos,
shall die.
Van a morir. Que nosotros vamos a estar destruidos, como este hermano que está aquí. Míralo ahí. Este hermano mentalmente está destruido. ¿Por qué? Porque tiene el niñito antocha, tiene muchas cosas que no están en la Biblia. You understand? ¿Dónde en la Biblia dice que nosotros estamos supuestos tener ídolos? ¿Dónde? En ninguna parte. El rosario, ¿ok? Es del demonio. You're out of your mind, bro. You need to repent. You have a chance to repent and come out of that wickedness. Brave people. Brave people talk in front. Come, let's talk. Let's learn. Come and learn.
We're fighting to come and learn.
We're fighting to come and learn.
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 18. What profiteth the graven image?
What profiteth the graven image that the maker thereof hath graven it? The molten image and a teacher of lies.
So the graven image, the molten image are both a teacher of lies. Okay? What your rosary, your crucifix in your house, the white image of Jesus Christ, that is going to get you death. You understand? That is a teacher of lies. Read on.
That the maker of his work trusteth therein to make dumb idols.
The reason why I say your idols are dumb is because they can't speak. They can't hear you when you make your prayers. They don't taste the food that you lay down on their feet. You understand? They don't go to sleep. They don't do anything. They're dumb. Your idols. La Guadalupe es el del diablo. Yes, I said it. Your so-called Virgen Maria, that white image, is of the devil. That's a dumb idol. All your so-called saints that are in your churches are dumb idols. That crucifix that was around your neck is a dumb idol. It has no value. Read on.
Woe unto him that saith to the wood, awake, to the dumb stone, arise, it shall teach.
You go ahead and you pray to these dumb idols. You go ahead and you pray, and you're into Santeria or Brujeria, whatever. These idols are not going to get you salvation. You are out of your mind. Come out of that and learn your true heritage. You have a chance to repent. And that's why we're here. We're giving you that opportunity to come and repent. Come out of that wickedness that you guys got. Come out of Christianity. Come out of Catholicism. Come out of Santeria. Learn your true heritage and learn what to do for the Most High God. Go ahead, pass. Learn your true nationality. Read on.
Behold, it is laid over with gold and silver, and there is no breath at all in the midst of it.
It's saying that there's no breath in the midst of it. There's no breath. It's not going to come alive and say, you know what, let me help you. It's not going to give you a couple of dollars so that they can get to your next train fare, you understand? It's not going to happen. Let's get into your history, all right? Because we've been up here, we've been talking about the history. Now it's time for you to learn your history. Who you are? Where did Puerto Ricans come from? Where did Latinos come from? Huh? What does the word Boricua mean? You know what Boricua means? Come. What does it mean?
It means you're
born. Huh? I can't hear you. Come. I can't hear you. What does it mean? Boricua does not mean your own country, bro. The word Boricua, what does the word Boricua mean?
Nothing at all.
No, that's not what it means. The word Boricua, let me help you. I'll help you. The word Boricua means brave Lord. The word Borinquen means land of the brave Lord. What does Taino mean? Bro, you got a hat that says Puerto Rico on it. You don't know what Taino is? You don't know? It's okay though. You're Puerto Rican?
Yeah.
What does Taino mean? You say it with such vigor and with such power. What does Taino mean? Okay. Taino means buena gente, or good people, noble people. That's what Taino means. However, these three words that we spoke about, Boricua, Borinquen, and Taino, these three words are not Spanish words. What are they? The Indians, or the quote-unquote Indians spoke Hebrew. These three words are Hebrew words. Now let me show you where we come from. Huh? Oh, that's right. The word, I'm glad you, thank you. Thank you very much, bro. What does the word Indio mean? La palabra Indio, ¿qué significa? The word Indio is a Latin word for slave, esclavo. That's what it means. Okay? You're not a slave, nor were our forefathers, but we went into slavery because we broke God's commandments. Watch this.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
All right? So us as Israelites, when we were in captivity, when we had just came out of Egypt, Moses has said that if we don't keep the commandments that God had ordained for us, that we will go into captivity, we will go into slavery, that we will pass through all the curses that are about to come out right now. Okay? Read 16.
Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Today, we're cursed in the city and we're cursed in the field. Right now, where are we right now? In Spanish, Harlem. Just found out not too long ago that the word Harlem is a slang word for Jerusalem. A Dutch slang word that means Jerusalem. Okay? Harlem, or Jerusalem. Okay? Right now, we're cursed in the city. Why? We live in the projects. We're on top of each other. Our stairwells smell like urine. Our people are bugged out on methadone. That's a curse in the city. Back then, cursed in the city meant that we were sold as slaves. Okay? But today, we live in dirt. Got gum on the floor, dirt on the floor, beer and all that stuff. You understand? Everyone's trying to threaten everyone else because they're mad. Read on.
Verse 16, cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Now the field is our workplace. Back then the workplace was the plantation. We worked from sunup to sundown with no rest. That's a curse. Today, the field is our job. Some of us got 2, 3, 4 jobs, and we break our backs, right? That's a curse. Is that not a curse? What do you say? That's not a life to live, bro. To bust your back all day long and barely see your family, that is a curse, bro. You understand? A blessing is you to be able to come to your house and your children are there waiting to meet you. And you can deal and help grow your family. You understand? That's a blessing. A curse is when you're not able to see that family because either they're asleep or they're gone, okay? And that's exactly what happened to our people. Go to 32.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Our children were given unto another people, okay? I'm gonna go back to you. In Puerto Rico, our people were sold to the other nations, okay? The Europeans came. And they took us, they took our children, and they gave them up to another family, up to another people. And we went into slavery. We not?
And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
He had no power in our hand to get our children back. Why? Because the Most High allowed that to happen. The Most High allowed that to happen because we broke God's commandments. Going back to Deuteronomy 28 and 15. It's the same thing. Keep reading it.
Verse 33. The fruit of thy land and all thy labor shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up, and thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always.
All right, our people have been crushed all way because these other nations took us and they ate of our fruit, the fruit of our land. They took of the benefits that we had that were made for us. They took it from us, and now we're not benefiting, but the other nations are. They're benefiting from our confusion of faces. They're benefiting that we don't know who we are and where we come from. They like it when you have a yin-yang that hands around your neck. They like it when you believe that you're Puerto Rican and you're not. They like it. The other nations love it that you think that you're Puerto Rican. They love it. But let them know that you're an Ephraimite, that you're from the 12 tribes of Israel, and see what happens. Now their faces are going to change. Now they're going to say, wait a minute, hold on for a second. This guy ain't confused no more. Wait a minute, you don't believe that you're a Puerto Rican anymore? You say you're an Ephraimite from the tribe of Israel, from the 12 tribes of Israel? Now it's an issue. But no, everyone else is going to go like this with their shirt. Hey, I'm Puerto Rican too. Keep hope alive in all this business. You're confused. You so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans have no idea who you really are. We're here to tell you. You are from the 12 tribes of Israel. You're not Puerto Rican. You're not Mexican. You're not Bolivian. You're not black. Black is a color in a crayon box. You understand that? You're not black. You're not African American. That's a lie. But you are an Israelite. Read on. Go to 40. Yeah, 40. 41.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 41. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity.
So we're going to be able to have children, but we're not going to enjoy our children because they're going into slavery. Yes, slavery is in the Bible. You understand? Our children were taken from us and they were made to work for another people, for another nation. Because we broke God's commandments. It goes back again to that's the whole root of our problems. The root of our problems is that we broke God's commandments. That's why we're stuck in drugs and alcohol. That's why we're stuck with cigarettes. That's why we're stuck with tattoos. That's why we're stuck in confusion of faces. Because we broke God's commandments. And we want to get wrapped up in Islam and all types of other religions that are garbage anyway. Read on.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments.
Because we choose not to listen to God's words. We want to listen to everyone else. We want to listen to the Most High. We don't want to listen to the Bible. When this Bible comes out, oh man, we're like dish, you know when dish soap hits oily water? We're like roach. We're that light when we turn on and the roaches leave. You understand? This Bible, that's exactly what it does. It removes all evil. You can't deal with it. You can't have it. It burns. You mean to tell me I can't buy and sell on the Sabbath? You mean to tell me that I can't sell coquito on Saturday because God says so? Oh, it burns. But listen, guess what? All, like Deacon Yawasop says all the time, all surgery hurts.
This is your surgery day.
That's right.
We are the doctors, just like Deacon Yahusab says, we're the doctors. And we're here to heal our people. Why? Because we love you. Listen, we got...
I'm not gonna feed into your emotions.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee, and shall pursue thee, and overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
And as a people, we have been destroyed because you think that we're racist. Do you know what the word racist really means? No. The word racist means to love a person that loves its own people, however, has the ability to prevent other people from doing other things. We don't have that power. You're partially correct. We love blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, but we don't have the power to stop the white man from coming into our community. We don't have that power. We don't have the power to take their children and convert them to something else. We don't have that power. However, the white man does. The white man has done that. They prevented us from learning. They prevented us from growing our own things. Okay? They prevented us from doing many things. We're not racist. But guess what? The nations around us are. Okay?
Ven acá para que tú aprendas lo que la Biblia está diciendo.
Yo creo en la Biblia.
Yeah, tú crees en la Biblia, pero tú sabes que tú eres de la tribu de dónde tú eres.
¿Cómo que de dónde soy?
¿De qué país?
Bueno, ahí estamos hablando. Mexicano.
Okay. Ven acá para que tú aprendas que los mexicanos son de Issachar. Ese es uno de los 12 tribus de Israel.
Yo sí me siento
Judío. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee, and shall pursue thee, and overtake thee, till thou be destroyed.
And our people are destroyed. Our people are mentally destroyed because they want to believe what they want to believe. But God says that brother over there is from Issachar. This brother over here is from Ephraim. They're both special men from the 12 tribes of Israel. But no, that's a problem. We're racist. God's racist, if anything. God is racist. He's the one that separated us from everyone else and told us that we're special. You so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Read on.
Yo, what's up, clown?
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. No. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
These curses are upon us for a sign and for a wonder. You understand? Why is it that we live in section 8? How come we're at the bottom of society? You ever thought about that? How come we're the last hired and the first fired? Why? It's because we broke God's commandments. It's because we broke God's commandments. The reason why we're in the situation, in the place that we're in today, is because we broke God's commandments. Listen, you could thumbs down all day you want. I still love you as a brother. And you still have a chance to repent. You're still an Israelite. I don't care how much you thumbs down all day long. You're still an Israelite. Repent and keep the commandments. That's what the Bible says. Read on.
Verse 47. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart, for the abundance of all things. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Today we serve our enemies. You have no idea what you're doing right now. You're serving your enemies. Okay? You're buying and selling on the Sabbath. You are serving the enemy. You understand? Buying and selling on the Sabbath is breaking God's commandments. Therefore, you are serving the enemy and you're not serving God. Read on.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
The Lord sent these enemies against us because we broke his commandments. Okay? Read that part again.
Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Today, blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, we serve our enemies. All right? The white man and the other nations are our enemies. They're not our friends. They put us in chains and in shackles.
and they brought us into a place where we don't deserve to be. But the Most High saw it deserving unto us because we broke his commandments. Read on.
Which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger.
In hunger. When you're hungry, you go to the supermarket and you buy food. But that food doesn't come from our own people.
What?
That food doesn't come from us. You understand? The food comes from the other nations. We don't have the ability to have our own. We don't take care of our own agriculture. Read on.
And in thirst.
And in thirst. You buy Dasani, Fiji. You buy all this water. That water doesn't come from us. That water comes from the nations. You understand? We don't have our own reservoirs. We don't have our own cisterns, is what the Bible calls it. Read on.
And in nakedness.
The clothes that you have on your back, made in China, made in Sri Lanka, made in Malaysia. We don't have the raw textiles to even make toilet paper. But we go to the other nations. We go to the white man and the other nations to get our things. We serve our enemies, read on.
And in want of all days.
Social Security, your birth certificate, your death certificate, okay? A mortgage, all the papers that you have, that special briefcase that you have in your house, all those papers that are in there came from the other nations. They didn't come from us. You have to serve your enemies. But you want to look like your enemies. You want to straighten your hair. You want to be like the other nations. And that's out of order. But, you done.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
The white man and the other nations put a yoke of iron on our neck. Everyone knows that, and that is not a racist statement. That's the truth. Even she knows it. That's just history. She knows that her forefathers put shackles and chains on our necks. She knows that. But look at our people. Oh, look how beautiful your dog is. You're beautiful. Your dog is so nice. You're so pretty, Miss White Woman. That's what they're doing right now. Yes, you, Metro PCS dudes. They serve the other nations. You understand? But let one of our people come with a dog. Are they going to stop? They're not going to stop. But they'll go ahead and stop for the white woman. Oh, good morning, Miss White Woman. You okay? Even if you don't speak English, Spanish people speak Spanish. Speak English. Oh, good morning. Good morning, Senorita. You okay? Right away. Read on.
Until he have destroyed thee.
And we are destroyed mentally, physically, spiritually. We're destroyed in this captivity. You understand? Destroyed spiritually. See that? Dressed like a man, straight hair, colored hair. Destroyed. Crazy. Oh, and that's a man. Holy crap. I was just looking at hair and pants. Look at that. All around confused. Confusion of faces.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
The Europeans came over here and destroyed us because they come from far away, from the other side of the ocean or the other side of the planet. Read on.
From the end of the earth.
From one end of the earth into another end. Go ahead.
As swift as the eagle flyeth.
You know what? Got proof right here. The eagle, okay? The eagle in Greece, in Rome, in Spain, and in America. And guess what? The Mexicans have an eagle on their flag. Little did they know that the eagle that is grabbing the snake is the Americans grabbing the Mexicans. And they give that honor. Ain't that something? Read on.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
Because we weren't speaking Spanish when the white man, when the conquistadors came over here, when Christopher Columbus came. We weren't speaking Italian and Latin and all that, so we were speaking Hebrew. We were speaking Hebrew. You understand? We weren't speaking Spanish. Okay, read on.
At ease.
A nation of fierce continents.
Meaning of faith, they are mad, angry. Read on.
Which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
And these people didn't give a damn about you, about all of us. They didn't give a damn about the old people. They didn't give a damn about the babies. Everyone got it. Everyone got destroyed. Go to 68 and we'll wrap it up with that.
I'll tell you, hook!
That is.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Egypt is a Greek word that means slavery or the house of bondage. Okay, read on. When you read it, Exodus chapter 20 and 2.
Go ahead.
With ships.
With cargo slave ships. That's how we got here. Okay? Blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, we went into slavery because we broke God's commandments. Read on.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
The same way Moses said it is exactly how it happened. You understand?
Yeah.
Read on.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
The it that we won't see anymore is our homeland, which is Jerusalem, which is the mother of us all. Read on.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
And here in America, and here in the other lands where we were put in slavery, we were sold into captivity as slaves. Blacks, Latinos, Native Americans. Read on.
For bond men and bond women.
For slave men and slave women, come on.
And no man shall buy you.
That's Marcus Garvey, couldn't save us. Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, the young lords couldn't save us. The Brown Berets couldn't save us. The Black Panther movement couldn't save us. The only one that can save us is Christ, the Black Messiah. Not that white guy that you have on top of your refrigerator. That guy's the devil. When you so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, you must repent and keep the commandments. Come back to your true heritage. Right?
Hello, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.